Hi, my name is Laura Dörr and I welcome you to my talk titled Tetra Pak Net for Corner-Based Object Detection in Logistic Fuse Cases. This is a topic I have been working on with a few colleagues of mine at the F3I Research Center for Information Technology in Karlsruhe, Germany. To give you a short motivation and an introduction into our use case, I want to talk about package name structure recognition. Package name structure recognition means we take a single RGB image showing one or more logistic transport unit and try to infer the packaging structure of these units. To solve that task of packaging structure recognition, we have defined an algorithm and image processing pipeline, which I want to run you to shortly. In the first step of inter-unit segmentation, we find all fully visible transport units within the image. In the second step, the intra-unit segmentation, a crop of each of that transport units is processed separately, and for each of that transport units, the two visible transport unit writes and all visible packaging unit faces are found. In the following step, transport unit byte analysis, we take each transport unit byte and make a rectified image of that transport unit byte and look at the packages to find the package arrangement and the number of packages within the transport unit byte. And in the last step of information consolidation, we put these two bytes back together and infer the overall arrangement and number of packaging units for that transport unit. For the topic of Tetra Pak Net, I want to focus on the transport unit byte segmentation. Transport unit byte segmentation means we need to find the two visible transport unit bytes of a transport unit. Important is it is not sufficient to find the bounding box or a rough instant segmentation mask of these bytes, but we need to find the four precise corner locations to perform the subsequent image rectification. In our first implementation, we started with an approach of first using an instant segmentation model, namely mask R3NN with an inception ReFNet V2 backend, and perform a post-processing step to simplify that mask to four precise corner locations by solving an optimization problem which places the four corner locations in such a way that the region induced by them has the highest overlap with the instant segmentation mask found by mask R3NN. Okay, but we thought maybe there's a better way to find tetragonal shaped objects and images than to do that workaround, and maybe we can define an object detection model which tries to find tetragonal objects right from the start. Okay, to define an object detection model performing tetragonal shaped object detection, we've started off with CornerNet, a quite famous work you might be familiar with. CornerNet performs bounding box based object detection by finding two key points, namely top left and bottom right bounding box corner of each object. We increase the number of key points for each object by an additional two to find the four corner locations for our object right ahead, and that is indicated in the images on the right side of the slide. In the top row, you can see the ground truth location for an example image for the four corner locations for both transport unit sites. There is a top left, a top right, a bottom left, and a bottom right corner indicated for each transport unit site. What we decided to do for now was to keep the corner pooling strategy as introduced by CornerNet, which means that we have to make assumptions on the order, on the arrangement of the corners of our tetragonal object, which means we have to formulate it like that, the top left, top right, bottom left, and bottom right corner, and have to make the assumption that top corners are placed further top in the image than their bottom counterpart, and left corners are placed further left than their right counterpart. Okay, to get to our data set, we have a data set of 1,257 images showing one or multiple transport units, which was acquired in an industrial plant in Germany. And we've split the data set into training, test, and evaluation data set to test our Tetra Pak Net. We trained Tetra Pak Net and the baseline model mask RVNN on two scenarios. In the first scenario, we took the whole images and trained both models on it. And in the second scenario, we took cropped images, each showing exactly one logistics transport unit. To evaluate both models, we took standard COCO average precision metrics. And what we can see in the results in the plot shown on the bottom part of the slide is that when we require low intersection over union thresholds, mask RVNN performs better than Tetra Pak Net. But when we increase that intersection over union threshold, which means when we only accept very high accurate, very precise detections, and we require very high accuracy from for our corner locations, Tetra Pak Net performs much better than mask RVNN. To illustrate that and to give you a short idea what it looks like, a few qualitative results, two examples on that slide. For each example, you can see the instant segmentation mask found by mask RVNN in the left image indicated in red, and the four corner locations placed by our post-processing step indicated as white, as black circles. In the right-hand image for each example, you can see Tetra Pak Net result illustrated in green. What you can see here is that the infant segmentation masks found by mask RVNN are often a bit fuzzy and not that accurate, which means that also the four corners placed by our post-processing step are not very precise and maybe a few pixels off in one direction. And Tetra Pak Net is able to place these corner locations more precisely. To sum that up and give you a short outlook, we introduced the use case of packaging structure recognition and the object representation of tetragonal shaped objects. And we adapted CornerNet to perform tetragonal object detection, and we call that new model Tetra Pak Net. We trained Tetra Pak Net on our use case specific data, and we evaluated it and tested it against baseline model mask RVNN and showed that for our use case, Tetra Pak Net is able to outperform the baseline model. In the future, we plan to do further evaluations of Tetra Pak Net, maybe on a different data set, or what we also haven't done so far is to evaluate the whole packaging structure recognition pipeline and to test how Tetra Pak Net can improve our overall results. Also, we aim to replace the pooling strategies to get rid of these shape restrictions I have talked about before. And what we also plan to do is to experiment with even higher specialized detection models with even more specific object representations for the use case of packaging structure recognition, which could mean that we design a model which is able to perform joint detection of both transport units wide or even of a whole logistics transport unit, including the base pallet and the lid. That's it for now. Thank you for your attention, and I welcome you to ask questions.